many, many signs. The ulama, the muhaddithin, have divided the signs of Qiyamah into two categories. One is alamatul kubra, and the other one is alamatul sugra. Alamatul sugra is minor sins. Alamatul kubra is major. Alamatul sugra is minor signs, and alamatul kubra is major signs of Qiyamah. Minor signs of Qiyamah have all been exposed, every single one of them. As for the major sign, even the door of alamatul kubra, the major sign, has been opened up. In the hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that the minute the very first sign, the major sign of Qiyamah, will be exposed, then all the other signs will follow each other very, very quickly, without any pause, without any delay, straight away. A beautiful example is given in the hadith. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, anybody got a tasbih with them here? Tasbih? There you are, you've got a tasbih, what you playing with it in Allah? In the hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us a beautiful example through the tasbih. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that it's like when, if the tasbih was to be broken, then it will only take time for the first bead to fall out from that tasbih. The minute the first bead falls out, the rest of the beads continuously follow the first bead, and until the entire tasbih is empty. And this is what Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. The minute the very first sign, the introduction of alamatul kubra, is visible, everything will follow very, very quickly, without any pause, no delay, straight away, instantly, all the signs will be visible. And the first sign of alamatul kubra is the coming of Imam Mahdi radiyallahu ta'ala. But before we go on to the subject of Imam Mahdi radiyallahu ta'ala, it's very, very important that we understand some of the basic alamat, the signs of Qiyamah. We are living in a very delicate time. In fact, the most unpredictable time. That is the time that we are living in. Nothing should surprise a Muslim today. If he is going to meet someone who is not a Muslim, or he could be a Muslim, whatever, nothing should surprise him. Anything and anything can happen anytime. We are living in the unpredictable time. And that time is to go anywhere. In the time, we have the internet, we have other sources, of information, books. But subhanAllah, nothing can be compared with the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith read to you in the khutbah is narrated by Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala an Anna Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, Badiru bil amali fitanan ka qita'il layl al muslim. Commit yourselves quickly to good actions before fitna, before him, darkness of the night, like the darkness of the night. The fitna will hit you strongly. So commit yourselves to good actions, amale saliha. And then Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives us the precise pinpoint condition of the hearts of people at that time. He says that يُصْبِحُ الرَّجُلُ مُؤْمِنًا وَيُمْسِي كَافِرًا. In that time, a believer will wake up in the morning with iman, but when the muazzin will give out the azan, the call for prayers, Maghrib Salah, he will become a kafir. وَيُمْسِي كَافِرًا. And vice versa. وَيُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا. In the evening he will be a mu'min, a believer. But by dawn, وَيُسْبِحُ كَافِرًا. In the morning he will become a kafir. Allahu Akbar. And the concluding words of the hadith again, يَبِيعُ دِينَهُ بِعَرَضٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. the condition of the believer at that time will be, he will be so low, the lowest of the low, that he will want to sell out his religion, his deen, the sharia, in order to acquire flimsy portion of dunya, some flimsy portion of dunya. Ek dunya ka koi hakir sa hissa lene ke liye apne deen ko wo bech dalega. In order to acquire a flimsy portion of dunya, he will be prepared to sell out his religion. SubhanAllah. And isn't that visible today, my respected brothers?